subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw. Welcome to Courts This Week at LiveLaw. I'm Sanya and I'm bringing this episode of the LiveLaw Weekly Roundup from home in light of the 21-day nationwide lockdown. Hoping everyone out there is safe and sound. Courts across the country have only been taking matters of extreme urgency and that too via video conferencing. Several courts, including the Supreme Court, issued specific guidelines for conducting hearings on VC. On Monday, March 23rd, the Supreme Court ran a trial of hearings via video conferencing where lawyers addressed the bench from separate designated areas within the court. However, after the nationwide lockdown announcement, office orders were issued for conducting hearings from home. In furtherance to this, a circular was issued and alternative apps such as WhatsApp, FaceTime and Skype were also accounted for to proffer successful hearings. Also, the offices of registry of the top court shall remain shut till April 15, 2020. Invoking its special powers under Article 142 of the Constitution, the Supreme Court passed a general order extending the limitation, whether condonable or not, with effect from March 15 until further orders. This was done in a suo motu case in order to ensure that lawyers and litigants do not have to come physically to file proceedings in various courts, and it shall bind all subordinate courts and tribunals in India. To avoid overcrowding in prisons in the wake of COVID pandemic, the Supreme Court directed all states and union territories to set up high-level committees which shall, in consonance with the state legal services authorities, determine class of prisoners who could be released on parole for 4 to 6 weeks. The bench observed that prisoners convicted of or charged with offences having jail term of up to 7 years can be given parole to decongest jails. Further, taking into consideration the possibility of outside transmission, it was directed that under trial prisoners should not be physically produced before courts and that video conferencing should be adopted for such purposes. A plea seeking an increase in testing laboratories and quarantine centres in view of the coronavirus outbreak in the country was heard by the CJI's bench, and it was directed that the said representations be considered as representations to the appropriate ministry. This direction was given while considering another PIL seeking closure of places of religious worship in order to ensure the implementation of social distancing. Following the clearance of Shaheen Bagh protest site by police in view of the lockdown imposed in Delhi, senior advocate Sanjay Hegde and advocate Sadhana Ramachandran were appointed as interlocutors by the Supreme Court in the issue, released a statement urging protesters to see the issue as not a question of win or lose, but stated that the grave pandemic threatening the country must receive top priority. The Supreme Court issued notice to the Centre and the Solicitor General in a petition seeking directions to the government for evacuation of about 850 Indian citizens stranded in Qom, Iran, amid the worldwide health emergency of the COVID pandemic. The petition averred that there was an urgent need for humanitarian assistance to be provided to pilgrims who are stranded in Qom. In light of the mobilization of people due to imposition of a national lockdown, advocate Vinod Yadav has written to Chief Justice of India seeking extension of the 30 days notice period required to be served before initiation of a criminal case for dishonor of checks under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instruments Act. In a slight relief for the automobile industry, the Supreme Court granted some relaxations to the March 31st deadline for the sale and registration of BS4 vehicles. The court allowed the sale of 10% of unsold BS4 compliant vehicles for 10 days after the end of the 21 days countrywide lockdown. However, such sale is not permissible in Delhi NCR. Sold BS4 vehicles have to be registered within 10 days of sale. A lawyer has filed a public interest litigation in the top court in an attempt to direct its attention towards the plight of migrant workers who, due to the nationwide lockdown, have had to embark on foot towards their native villages, which may be hundreds of kilometers away.
The indulgence of the Supreme Court is sought on the ground that though the central and state governments are making sincere efforts to redress their grievances, traveling or stranded migrant workers are unable to avail the benefits of such government schemes. The High Court could not have directed the registration of an FIR, said the Supreme Court in a judgment reiterating the observations in celebrated judgment of Sakiri Vasu versus State of Uttar Pradesh. Now let's find out developments in the High Courts and other courts. Since the announcement of a nationwide lockdown, various High Courts, including the Delhi, Bombay, Kerala, Karnataka, Madras, Calcutta and Andhra Pradesh High Court, among others, remain shut except for hearing matters of extreme urgency and that too via video conferencing. A number of High Courts extended interim orders and limitation periods for filings during the lockdown. The Guwahati High Court granted bail to Akhil Gogoi, who is facing charges of waging a war for his involvement in protests against Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. In Suo Motu proceedings, the High Court of Jammu and Kashmir passed a series of orders to ensure social distancing so as to break the transmission cycle of the deadly virus. Bench took a stern view against the persons who conceal their foreign travel history, despite clear directions from both the centre and the Union Territory Administration. The Gujarat High Court dismissed a writ petition which challenged the right of the Bar Council of India and Bar Council of Gujarat to levy, as well as increase the fee for enrolment of advocates and issuance of certificate of practice, as stipulated under the Advocates Act and Bar Council of India rules. Amid the COVID-19 pandemic, the Andhra Pradesh High Court directed the central and state governments to ensure that health workers have necessary personal protective equipments such as the N95 masks, sterile medical gloves, starch apparels, personal protection equipment and all other necessary things. The Delhi government informed the Delhi High Court that it was proposing to bring out an array of changes in the Delhi prison rules to deal with the growing concern of coronavirus. In addition to this, a temporary facility for special furlough will be introduced for those category of prisoners and for such number of days as may be specified in the order. The Delhi High Court heard a plea seeking evacuation of students stranded in Kazakhstan due to the lockdown in light of the coronavirus outbreak. Earlier in the week, the bench directed that a nodal officer from the Indian embassy be appointed for looking into the issue. On the next date of hearing, bench disposed of the plea, satisfied with the steps taken by the government in this regard. The Gujarat High Court, after hearing arguments via video conferencing, reserved its order in a petition seeking directions to the government to supply enough stock of personal protective equipment to healthcare workers stationed at the front line to treat the patients of the deadly COVID-19. The Bombay High Court has issued directions to ensure utmost care regarding the treatment and prevention of the virus. The bench stressed on the need to ensure availability of adequate number of testing centers and requisite medical equipments. A criminal complaint was filed against singer Kanika Kapoor before a Bihar court on Saturday, accusing her of neglecting and disobeying an order issued by a public servant to prevent the spread of the novel coronavirus. The matter will come up for hearing on March 31st. According to reports, the Bollywood celebrity landed in Lucknow from the United Kingdom and was admitted to a city hospital after she showed signs of flu and tested positive for COVID. So that's all for this week. If you enjoy our videos, please don't forget to like and share them. For similar videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next week, and I hope everyone's safe out there.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw.